What's up, people? This is No Name Boxing TV, aka the Pugilist World Legend, and I come to break dinner with niggas. Shout out to Roy Jones Jr., okay? He got the stoppage of Eric Watkins, who was a stand-in. He was a replacement, you know what I'm saying? He knocked him out in the sixth round at Foxwoods Casino. And I want to take this time to shout out to Foxwoods, man. Okay, I haven't been there in years. The last time I was there, I saw a fight. My baby mother, you know what I'm saying, sent me out there. We went out there together, but it was her, you know, it's for my birthday gift. You know what I'm saying? We went out there and at Foxwoods to see a fight with Devin Alexander. He fought somebody. Oh, I forgot the dude's name, man. But Devin knocked that nigga out with a sick uppercut, man. He was catching uppercuts like crazy. Devin definitely got the stoppage. It was an entertaining fight, entertaining card. Fox was a great casino, and I gotta say, man, yo, their lobsters, yo, shout out to my baby mother, man, because that fucking lobster was like almost $70 to $80, man. And that lobster was, to this day, is the biggest lobster I ever had in my life. That motherfucker was big as fuck. It took us like almost an hour to eat that shit. Well, mainly she fed it to me, but like she had to help me. That motherfucker was so goddamn big, man. I swear to God, man. But yeah, shout out to Foxwoods, man. Real shit. Congratulations to Roy Jones for getting a stoppage. He's still going strong. He's 46 years old. You know, he's still out there doing his thing, man. And it prompted me to do a video about this man. And, you know, I've been thinking, and, you know, Roy Jones is my favorite fighter. I'm going to put it out there like that. He's my favorite fighter in terms of skill, in terms of me watching him fight. It is what it is. And his prime, between whenever, I think it was like 89, he started his career to like 2000, like 2003, when he fought Ruiz. And this is like prime Roy Jones, okay? Pound for pound. I would put him in the ring against anybody and got him winning, okay? He is, in my opinion, the Michael Jordan of boxing. You heard it from me. This is my opinion. Listen, it's not a fact. Of course, we don't have, you know, actual stat proof. No. This is my opinion, okay? And, you know, I've seen a lot of great fighters. This is who I've seen in my lifetime watching boxing. Roy Jones Jr. is the Michael Jordan of boxing. Okay? Yeah, niggas say I'm wilding for that shit. But I'm talking about with technical skill. I ain't talking about with greatness. Okay? There are greater fighters than Roy Jones. Yes, there are greater fighters than Roy Jones. Okay? I want to repeat that for y'all niggas. But in terms of skill and ability, my niggas, man. Yo, I'll put Roy Jones against anybody between 1989 and 2003 when he fought John Ruiz for the heavyweight title. After that, he was done. You know what I'm saying? I think because him being 34, you know, coming back down to light heavyweight, fucked him up. That first Tarver fight, it fucked him up, man. You know what I'm saying? With him being an, you know, athletic skill type box base type of fighter, you know, and you're losing almost 20 pounds to make weight, like, and you're 34 years old, and it's a comment. He got old and got drained at the same time. I had him edging Tarver in the first fight. He rightfully won that fight. Yes, there were questions. Right then and there, I said he should retire. And once they talk about him having a rematch, this is the first time ever. It hurt me, man. You niggas don't understand, man. This shit motherfucking hurt me to go against Roy Jones in that fight. The second fight I had Tarver winning. I didn't have him knocking him the fuck out like he did. But he was going to win the fight. Roy Jones was no longer the Roy Jones he once was. Okay, he would have went up to heavyweight, came back down. It just took too much out of him, and he got old. Everything, he got way slower. Like, he was nowhere near the fighter he was before he went up and fought John Ruiz Like, it fucked with him, you could tell. And it just hurt me, man. For him to get knocked out like that, it just, yo. And then with Glenn Johnson, it was hard to watch, man. It was hard to watch him go through all that, man. You know what I'm saying? Ever since then, like, you know, he's getting stopped by journeyman niggas, man. Like, you know, but hey, you know what I'm saying? He's a fighter. He's a warrior. You know what I'm saying? Should he retire a long time ago? Yes. Yes. But he has that, you know, that fire that Muhammad Ali had, that Sugar Ray Leonard had. He had that fire to fight. He wanted to fight. You know what I'm saying? We can't tell him, yes, yeah, from the outside looking in, and we're right. You know, we could tell these people because we, you know, stop fighting because we want to remember you for how great you are. And, you know what I mean? We don't want you losing to these journeyman type fighters or these fighters, you know, of course, want to have no chance against you in your heyday. You know what I'm saying? But these guys got the fire, man. You can't tell these niggas not to fight, man. Like, you can't. You know? They don't fuck around and knock you out. You know what I'm saying? It's just, you know. And, you know, he's 46, man. That shit happened a long time ago, man. It was like 12 years ago, like, when that shit started happening to him. And he's still going, man. That's props to him, man. That's props to him. You know what I'm saying? He'll show flashes of greatness, like when he fought Trinidad. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, a 38-year-old fucking Roy Jones easily beat Trinidad. And people say he didn't have, you know, boxing skill. He just relied on athleticism and stuff like that. I mean, listen, you can't stop Tito Trinidad or, like, someone his caliber at 38 years old without having, you know, boxing skill. He just didn't have the speed or athleticism. Imagine if he would have fought him back. So I keep trying to tell niggas, man, like, Roy Jones was, he was generations ahead of his time, okay? He made great fighters look terrible. You know what I'm saying? He easily beat B-Hop. You know what I'm saying? It wasn't too much of an entertaining fight, but because, you know, Roy Jones dominated him. You know what I mean? And then we come to find out after the fight, he broke his hand. So he easily beat a prime B-Hop. You know what I mean? With one hand. Understand? Easily. Okay, now, is B-Hop a greater fighter in terms of accomplishments? Yes, he is. Yes, he is. B-Hop is a great, like, he's in terms of accomplishments and what he's done, especially we, you know, he's 50 years old, winning championships. Yeah, he accomplished a lot more than Roy Jones, but was he a better fighter than Roy Jones? Hell motherfucking no. Hell motherfucking no. And there was a reason why Bernard Hopkins stayed in the middleweight division all these years, and he dominated. He rightfully dominated. Once Roy Jones left and went to super middleweight, you know, it was B-Hop's division. You know what I'm saying? He didn't want to come up because he knew. He knew. You know what I'm saying? You know the backstory between them two. It could have been a rematch a long time ago. Okay? At middleweight. And super middleweight. You know, but it was the money. 60-40. B-Hop didn't want to do it. I don't understand why. You lost, bro. Like, you lost. I think it was just bullshit. He knew he was going to get beat again. He was bullshitting. You know what I'm saying? I have respect for B-Hop, but I think that was one guy he clearly ducked. It was one guy he clearly didn't have confidence of beating, and that was Roy Jones. Okay? I don't give a fuck what nobody said. Yes, B-Hop is great, but he was not fucking with Roy Jones at all. You know what I'm saying? That's a fact. He proved it. He beat him easily in the first fight. Easily. I didn't give a fuck about that second fight. Like, it was like, what year was that shit? Let me look this shit up, my niggas, man. Pot at me real quick, man. You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, when the fuck did these niggas fight again? All right. B-Hop. Where you at, B-Hop? Where you at, B-Hop? I'm going to holler at you real quick. Okay, 2010. Okay? 2010. This is 7 years after he got knocked out by motherfucking Antonio Tarver. Okay? Actually, it was 6 years. Pardon me. He got knocked down 2004. Okay, 6 years after. Okay? Like, and their first fight was in 1993. So you mean to tell me 17 years later? Like, come on, man. 17 years later, you have the rematch? Like, I don't count that fucking fight. Yeah, B-Hop won, but I don't give a fuck about that. It's 17 fucking years later, man. Like, come on, man. Roy Jones was nowhere near. He's even lost even more since 2003, 2004. Okay? So, nah, B-Hop. I'm not giving you that. You know what I'm saying? I'm not giving you that shit. I don't give a fuck. I'm not. But Roy Jones had great fights. You know what I'm saying? He beat James Toney. When James Toney was pound for pound. He was pound for pound, one of the top fighters in the world. He handled him easily. Easily. Niggas was getting mad about it. I said, yo, like, James Toney? Nah, he's gonna knock that nigga out. I said, No. Roy Jones is in a world of his own. Because nobody was a believer of Roy Jones, man. Like, niggas had James Toney beating Roy Jones at that time. Because, you know, James Toney was knocking out niggas, man. Yo, he was fearsome, man. You know? He was pound for pound. But, you know, James Toney had weight problems. He was up and down, fluctuating between light heavyweight and super middleweight. You know, like, he always had weight problems, man. And it wouldn't fucking matter, man. It didn't fucking matter. Roy Jones easily beat him. Easily beat him. It wouldn't matter how much he fucking weighed, man. Roy Jones would have beat James Toney. You know what I'm saying? He handled him. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, but, yo, it was just easy fights after that, man. Like, Benny Pazienza. You know, another entertaining fight. You know, Pazienza was game. You know, it was one of my favorite Roy Jones fights, man, by the way. You know, one of my all-time favorites. Roy Jones beat the shit out of fucking Benny Pazienza. Beat the shit out of him. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, man. He just made things look so easy, man. Easy. You know, and then we're gonna talk about fucking, what's his name? What's that nigga name, man? Montel Griffin. Okay? And he easily beat, you know, Montel Griffin. You know, he's beating his ass. You know, he's about to stop him in the ninth round. And then he gave him that little extra punch in the head, and they disqualified him. You know what I'm saying? Took his O. Understand? And you know what's funny to this day, man? I don't know. They had some kind of ceremony with Montel Griffin, you know. Talk about he's, you know, some Hall of Fame. They actually got him in the Hall of Fame, man. Like, I'm like, whatever, man. He was a decent fighter, but he wasn't, you know what I'm saying? He wasn't nothing great. He wasn't a great fighter. He was okay. And they even had him saying of his accomplishments, he beat Roy Jones. I gotta laugh at that dumb shit. Like, what the fuck are these niggas talking about? He's about to get stopped, okay? He just threw one more punch extra that got him disqualified. And they're gonna give him, they're gonna credit him as a victory over Roy Jones? And then, you saw what happened the next fight. He blew him away in the first round. Destroyed him. So I don't even know why in the fuck they even tried to credit him of that win. Like, I don't, you know what I'm saying? But, yeah, Roy Jones was pound for pound king. You know, they used to get on him. You know, so that's why I like, you know, I kind of relate with Triple G. You know what I'm saying? Because, you know, he's going through the same bullshit, you know, Roy Jones went through. And also, Marvin Hagler, he went through it too. You know what I'm saying? But like Roy Jones, he didn't have no competition. Okay? He came around the time. Same with Mike Tyson in the 80s. He came around a time there wasn't really nobody he could fight. But Roy Jones did have he had more competition than Mike Tyson did. You know what I'm saying? You know, he had James Toney. You know, he had Benny Pazienza. He had guys like that. You know, I'm gonna call him Mike McCallum. I don't know. Mike McCallum was okay, man. You know, I guess, you know, his recent stories that he talked about, like Hagler and fucking Sugar Ray Leonard ducked him. I don't believe that dumb shit. Fuck up out of here, man. He wasn't good enough to fight them niggas, man. Come on, man. He was a decent fighter, too, but not great. You know what I'm saying? But, yeah, he just didn't have... It wouldn't matter who was around, okay? You know, Roy Jones was pound-for-pound king when guys like Julio Cesar Chavez was around. Pernell Sweet Pea Whitaker was around. Oscar De La Hoya, Bernard Hopkins. He was pound-for-pound king. Okay, he was pound for pound king, number one fighter in the world. Okay, and these are all great fighters, man. Tito. You know what I'm saying? Like, he was pound for pound. He was just that fucking great, man. Like, nobody was fucking with this nigga, okay? People say he didn't, you know, he didn't have a jab. He did have a job. A jab, excuse me. He had a job with his boxing. But he had a jab, too. He just didn't enforce it. He didn't need it. You know, he was so athletically gifted. You know, he made his own shit happen. Like, power shots, hooks. You know what I'm saying? Like, he could hit a nigga anytime. Because we all know jabs set up other shit. You know? Like, Roy Jones get into a combination without a jab. He'll do 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 punch combination on niggas. Without a jab. Without a jab. Okay? He was lightning fast. His hand speed was second to none. You know what I mean? I think it's something like, even nowadays, niggas telling about Floyd Mayweather. Listen. Pretty Boy Floyd, we ain't talking about money. We're talking about Pretty Boy when he was at his top form, you know what I'm saying? You know, when he was engaging with niggas, and you know what I'm saying? Yes, he had great hand speed, but he was too small, okay? Roy Jones will fucking annihilate him, okay? Annihilate him. Why do you think Floyd is afraid? I won't say he's afraid, but it's a high risk to fight Amir Khan. Like, he ducked Amir Khan when he fought fucking, what's his face? Chino Maidana. It was an easier fight. And the only reason why he had that pole, because he assumed, because Chino, you know, fucked up Adrian Broner, niggas were gonna pick Maidana over Amir Khan, but niggas still picked Amir Khan over Chino Maidana. He said, no, fuck that, I wanna fight Maidana. I gotta avenge little bro. Nah, nigga. Amir Khan is a headache for you. Okay? Can he beat Khan? Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Definitely beat Khan. But his style is a headache for someone like Floyd Mayweather. You know what I'm saying? A great technical boxer with power, hand speed, that could overwhelm him. He could definitely outpoint him and outwork him. He will overwhelm. But listen, let's go back. In the 90s, there was a fighter similar to him, which was Pernell Sweet Pea Whitaker. He was a pound-for-pound king as well at one point. You know what I'm saying? You know? He had problems with both De La Hoya and Felix Trinidad because they were technical boxers that had power and a high work rate. They overwhelmed Pernell Whitaker. If you want to see a possible outcome of a fight between Floyd Mayweather and Amir Khan, look at De La Hoya and Felix Trinidad against Pernell Whitaker. That is what Floyd is afraid of. Okay? A big dude, about the same size as Floyd, coming at you. He's going to outwork. He's not going to wait for you to pot shot him. He can steal rounds. You know what I'm saying? He has the Olympian pedigree. You know what I'm saying? He's a problem. You know? Now, Amir Khan don't want to shut the fuck up. He is doing a lot of fucking talking. You know what I'm saying? But his style is a headache for someone like Floyd Mayweather. And that's why you'll probably never see that fight. You know what I'm saying? Roy Jones against Floyd Mayweather? Come on, man. Come on, man. It's not even a motherfucking fight, man. It's not even a fucking fight. He has nothing for Roy Jones. Okay, nothing. Okay? Let's just stay on Roy Jones, you know. You know, as you know, 2003, 2004 came, you know, he had, you know, Tarver problems. You know, he got knocked out. It was, you know, man, my heart was broken when he got knocked out like that. Like, I felt bad, man. And I knew he was going to lose that fight, but I thought it was going to be a decision. I didn't think he was going to get knocked out like that. You know what I'm saying? Like, that was crazy. You know, and then, you know, Glenn Johnson did him dirty. Like, man, like that Glenn Johnson one. That Glenn Johnson one. And that was supposed to be a tune-up for our next Tarver fight. You know, but like Roy Jones was so shot as a fighter, he couldn't move. Like, he was a sitting target. You know, Roy Jones move around. He's like quickness, can use his hand speed. This is when he didn't know his shit was gone. he found out again the hard way. Glenn Johnson, you know, knocked him the fuck out. It was even worse. I'm like, you know, like, I've been wanting him to retire, man, after that first Tarver fight. Like, when he edged Tarver, I was like, yo, it's time for you to retire. But, like, how can you tell someone like that to retire as great as he was? You know, even his trainer. Like, after the second Tarver fight, when he got knocked out, Jim Lampley was saying that his trainer was saying that Roy Jones got old. You say he, you know, in camp, he looked very old and slow. He's nothing compared to what he used to be. You know what I'm saying? And, you know, niggas is hating on Roy Jones now because, you know, he fought too long. He took too many L's, got knocked out. Now he's not great. Nah, man, come on. You know what I'm saying? That's like saying, okay, look at Sugar Ray Leonard, right? Look at Sugar Ray Leonard. He got stopped by Hector Macho Camacho, Terry Norris. Them dudes stopped him. Are those guys greater than Sugar Ray Leonard? Hell, motherfucking no. So you mean to tell me fucking Antonio Tarver and Glenn Johnson could beat Roy Jones in his prime? You mean to tell me Macho Camacho and Terry Norris will be able to beat Sugar Ray Leonard in his prime? Hell, motherfucking no. Come on now. Stop being coincidental, okay? Roy Jones is an all-time great. In his prime, I will put Roy Jones in the ring from middleweight to light heavyweight, okay? From 89 to 2003 against anybody of all time, anybody, and winning, okay? I got him beating motherfucking Marvin Hagler. Okay, I got him beating Sugar Ray Leonard. Okay? Duran. Tommy Hearns. Triple G. Because he's the new, like, Hagler of today. Triple G is. He beats Triple G easily. As great as Triple G as a fighter, great power, he's not fucking with Roy Jones at middleweight. I got Roy Jones all day. All day. Yeah, man. You know what I'm saying? And then you like, niggas is hollering at me about fucking Joe Calzaghe. How he beat Roy Jones. Like, where the fuck was this nigga at? Yo, he was a lifetime super middleweight. What the fuck is you saying? Only person he beat was Kessler. Like, okay. He beat Kessler. Where's this dude at where Roy Jones was at light heavyweight? He came up because he beat Bernard Hopkins. You know what I mean? He was at light. He, as great as he wasn't a prime Bernard Hopkins. Like, come on, man. They say he's the best super middleweight because he beat Roy Jones and B-Hop and Kessler. You know what I mean? But other than that, he fought in Australia. He was the Andre Ward of Australia. That's where he fought, in the UK. You know what I'm saying? Like, come on, man. Like, stop. Stop. I think Carl Froch is greater than Calzaghe. You mean to tell me Joe Calzaghe is a greater fighter than Roy Jones? You mean to tell me Joe Calzaghe is a greater fighter than B-Hop? Hell, motherfucking no. Both those dudes in their prime, super middleweight, Roy Jones, super middleweight, will destroy Joe Calzaghe. Destroy him. A prime Roy Jones, super middleweight. Okay? Don't even talk to me about that shit, man. You know? Yes, he's guilty of fighting too long. You know what I mean? But Roy Jones is a great fighter. He's not the greatest, no. You know, I think he needed to do more things. You know what I'm saying? But, yo, he had the career he had. He fought who he had to fight. They put in front of him. You know what I'm saying? You know? Now, Bernard Hopkins, is he a greater fighter than Roy Jones? Yes, he accomplished a lot more than Roy Jones did. And he had, you know, a longer career in terms of longevity, in terms of what who we fought, he lasted longer. You know what I'm saying? Because he was a more defensive, you know, more conservative fighter. You know, defense, great fighter. Like, he was, you know, he had more conventional. You know what I'm saying? Great fighter. Iron chin, man. Iron chin, B-Hop. You know what I'm saying? But is he a better fighter in terms of skill than Roy Jones? Hell, motherfucking no. We've been proved that already. Why you think he had a fucking rematch 17 years later? 17 years? Honestly. Like, come on, man. Come on. He didn't want none of Roy Jones' problem when he's in his fucking prime. And niggas know that. That was probably the only one person he was afraid of. Was Roy Jones. He got better after that first fight. He got better after that first fight. Understand? So, like, every fighter has that one person they have problems with. You know what I'm saying? Like, De La with Shane Mosley. You know, Shane Mosley with Vernon Forrest. You know? Evander Holyfield with Riddick Bowe. You know what I'm saying? Like, they all have, like, problems. B-Hop's problem was Roy Jones. He had Roy Jones problems. You know what I'm saying? But pound for pound, from middleweight to light heavyweight of all time, you know, say no disrespect to anybody else that was around, you know, in that weight class, whatever, or any fighter of all time, whatever. I'm talking about skill-wise. I got Roy Jones against anybody. 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 You know what I'm saying? I'm not going to get hate for this shit, but I don't give a fuck. This is just how I feel, man. He was untouchable. Untouchable. Okay? He's the Michael Jordan of boxing. You know what I'm saying? Only difference is Michael Jordan is the greatest basketball player of all time. He really is. Roy Jones ain't the greatest boxer of all time. No, he's not. But he's the best fighter to me. Skill-wise, he was like a genetic freak to me, man. He did things no other fighter could ever do. Ever do. I got my money on Roy Jones and his prime against anybody. Anybody. I don't give a fuck who it is, man. Between middle to light heavyweight. Yes, he won a heavyweight title. He beat John Ruiz, but he didn't fight enough in heavyweight. Even though he's fighting heavyweight now in these latter days or whatever. You know what I'm saying? But he's mainly a middle to light heavyweight. Okay? So, I got him winning. It's anybody. Prime Roy Jones. Anybody. I don't give a fuck who it is. You know what I'm saying? And like I said before, I'm sorry, I keep repeating myself. Yes, are there greater fighters? Yes, there are greater fighters. But in terms of better fighters, skill-wise, nah. Roy Jones was that nigga. It is what it is. I don't care who the fuck beats him. I don't give a fuck who knocks him out now. You know what I'm saying? I don't give a fuck. Okay? Because none of them niggas would fuck with him in his prime. None of them. I don't give a fuck who it is. Any guy that beat Roy Jones after 2003, it's not fucking with him before 2003. It is what it is. They would have fought him head up in his prime. They would have fucking lost. They would have lost bad. And people gotta understand too, man. Like, you know, when he was beating everybody in his prime, he wasn't even going his hardest. He actually went his hardest against Montel Griffin. Notice he went 9 rounds with Montel Griffin, stopped him. He's going to stop him. The rematch, he fucked him up in the first round. Destroyed him. Wasn't even fucking close. He made an example of what he could do when he wants to fight. You know? Because he was so great, he was showcasing. You know? Showcasing. And these guys were ranked fighters. They just wasn't nowhere near good as him. It is what it is. You know? Pound for pound fighters that he fought was James Toney and Bernard Hopkins. He beat them easily. Be hot with one hand. It's a fact. You know what I'm saying? But anyway, this video's going a little bit too long, man. Let me know what you think. Do you think Roy Jones was the best fighter skill-wise of all time with athleticism and, you know, skill and stuff? If not, who do you have? You know, holler at me in the comment section. You know what I'm saying? Like, dislike, subscribe. This is No Name Boxing TV, and I'm out. Deuces.